Hi, this is Dr. Bamberg. Welcome to the last video in our series this fall on the ABCs of Design for the University of Utah's ME1000 class. I do want to note that if you want more information, a fantastic resource is Engineering Design by Dim and Little. We use this resource a lot in developing our ABCDs, and there is a copy available on reserve in the Marriott Library. Today we will be talking about the E phase of design, specifically evopteration, which is a great word coined by our own Dr. Romer. Evopterate refers to the fact that designs evolve and are optimized when designers iterate through multiple attempts. We'll look at each of these separately. First, let's look at how designs evolve as various models are built, tried, found wanting, and then new ideas are generated. Consider the evolution of bicycle design. Baron von Dry invented the running machine, or Lauf machine, in 1817. The English version was called the hobby horse. These featured two inline wheels and the ability to steer. Louis Gumperz added a hand-driven ratchet mechanism to the front wheel of a hobby horse in 1821. Kirkpatrick Macmillan is traditionally credited with a machine in which power was supplied to the back wheel via rods connected to treadle-type pedals. Pierre Lalemant and his investor James Carroll were granted a U.S. patent for a pedal-powered two-wheeler in 1866. In 1870, James Starley produced the aerial high-wheeler, and later versions had front wheel sizes of up to 5 feet. The larger wheels allowed the rider to travel further with a single pedal rotation. In 1879, Henry J. Lawson patented a rear-wheel chain-driven safety bicycle, the Bicyclette. Lawson's earlier designs were lever-driven. There's no reason to still have the big wheel now that there is gearing, but you can see it remains. So who invented the bicycle? There's no single inventor, but the names mentioned here, along with many others, all contributed critical elements to early bicycle design. The Starley family of England can perhaps be given credit for combining it all into their Rover in 1885, the first commercial venture. Further improvements to bicycles have included braking assemblies, safety features, lightweight material, suspension systems, but the basic design of a bicycle has remained the same. Rear wheel chain driven, front wheel steering, upright rider, wheels of similar size. Of course, there are other designers out there hoping their next great evolution will catch your imagination and cause you to purchase their new bike. Next, we'll discuss optimization, but note that optimization in design is not necessarily the same as classical mathematical optimization procedure. For some objectives, it may be, but since there are generally so many objectives to be met, and many of which are subjective, it's not necessarily a mathematical optimization. Safety is an objective that every engineering project must consider. Let's think about how the automobile industry has optimized safety. In early automobiles, the passenger locations were typically quite high in cars that had a high center of mass. In addition, the passengers did not have safety harnesses or windshields. These were obviously safety concerns because the high center of mass made rollovers more likely. And if you hit something, you could go flying or you could be hit by low-hanging branches. In 1919, 90% of cars had only a one-person top and side curtains, and a windshield was a luxury. By 1929, 9 out of 10 cars were now equipped with glass all around to provide protection from wind, rain, mud splashes, road dust, and flying debris. Initially, common glass was used, but would shatter when broken. Laminated safety glass was introduced in 1928 and held the shards of glass in place, greatly reducing injuries. In the 1930s, the fatality rate per 100 million vehicles miles traveled was 15.6. Currently, it is down below 1.8. Safety became a much higher focus for the auto industry. In 1930, GM performed the first barrier crash test. The first crash test dummy was Sierra Sam, developed for the military in 1949 for evaluation of aircraft ejection seats. Swedish inventor Nils Bohlin invented the three-point seatbelt that was introduced by Volvo in 1959. This is considered the modern seatbelt and is standard on cars today. However, safety harnesses had been around since the 1800s with the first U.S. patent for automobile seatbelts issued to Edward Cleghorn of New York, New York, way back in 1885. Patents for the idea of an airbag were first awarded in the 1950s. However, it wasn't until 1968 that Alan Breed invented a sensor and safety system, the world's first electromechanical automotive airbag system. In the 1970s and 80s, most car manufacturers started adding airbags as an option. In 1998, a law was passed making airbags standard in all new cars. Both evolution and optimization lead to new design iterations. Essentially, it's hard to get things right the first time, so multiple attempts result in improved designs. We use both terms because sometimes designs evolve without necessarily getting better. You may have noticed this already in your design project. It is very important to leave sufficient time in your project planning for building and testing prototypes. and then for more redesigning and testing. To explore this full process further, let's look at the iPod, which was a very good idea. A clever combination of two existing ideas, a music player and a digital storage device. One of Apple's biggest strengths has been getting input from the customer quickly incorporated into new iterations of their product. The iPod was first introduced in October 2001. It promised to allow you to hold thousands of songs in your pocket with its 5 gigabytes of internal memory for only $400. By July 2002, due to customer demand, prices dropped and a 10 and 20 gigabyte version were available. In April 2003, the iPod 3G was released, which was lighter, smaller, and had no moving parts. However, part of this evolution was initially not an improvement because the controls were too sensitive. Ultimately, the controls were optimized, resulting in the now distinctive click wheel iteration. In January 2007, the iPhone was released, followed by the iPod Touch, basically the iPhone minus the phone, in September 2007. As a final note, both failure and success play an important role in the evaporation of designs. Don't accept success with a given model as a stopping point. Although a 1 million iPods sold by June 2003 was remarkable at the time, that number is dwarfed by the 275 million iPods sold by September 2010. In addition, it is essential to make sure that you learn from failure and use that knowledge to improve your designs. Thank you for listening to this fall's series of videos for the ME1000 Introduction to the Design of Robotic Systems class for freshman mechanical engineering students at the University of Utah.